Hi guys, welcome to Best of Guru channel, and today we have another special guest in our channel. I will introduce her before taking over to her. She is none other than Shanti Kiran, and I know her since 2015. Shanti Kiran has started her blogging, but apart from blogging, she also do lot of things online, like business consulting. She is also a writer, columnist, and she does everything. She is a multi-talented person. Thing I like more about Shanti is that she is very straightforward, transparent, and very dynamic woman on social media. One of the few women who I saw very strong at heart, or maybe very fierce, is Shanti. Whenever I see her Facebook post and all, I get motivated as well as I get lot of information, and those are very heart touching also, few of them. Whenever you need help, you can always try one name, that is Shanti. She is one of the good helper in terms of any service needed. When there is a need for anyone online, she is always there to help people. Such a kind and good hearted person. Let us introduce Shanti. Hi Shanti Garu.
Hello. Hello Gurnath. How are you?
Yeah, I am fine. How about you?
Very fine. Nice to know you, Gurnath Garu. Since like 2015, we have been interacting. So I learned a lot from you. I've seen how you built a blog from this scratch and grown it to thousands of people audience. That was really wonderful. I remember you asking me certain things, and later, you know, you are now I have to ask you many things and learn from you. That transition is really great.
Yeah. Can you please tell something about you and your education, your background, family background, and how did you come to online, and how you have improved yourself?
I started working at the age of 20 because we had financial issues, so I had to work. So right after my BCom, I jumped into working at the Standard & Poor's, Capital IQ at that time. I worked there around 5 years like that. And in 2010, I quit my job. I got married. Motherhood followed pretty soon. I did not expect that. So then that was the harsh reality for me. My family background being job holders, typical job holders. So we don't know anything except education and job. When I did not know what to do in that transition phase, all my childhood came back. Like I grew up in Karnataka in a town called Bidar. If you know, it's known for the Air Force Station, and the bank people used to come there on transfers. So there were many languages out there, Punjabi, Marathi, Kannada, Hindi, and Tamil people were there. And we were Telugus. Telugus were also very big in number. So I had knowledge of all the languages. And from Hyderabad, we went to Pune. It wasn't very difficult for me. In Pune, you know, we had Symbiosis very near my home. There was Viman Nagar, where all the offices were there, MNCs. Again, with a small baby, I could not work. I was disappointed, like what to do with my life. Then I completed my MCom like that. MCom is through distance I completed. I completed it successfully. Then I took up ICWA without any coaching, ICWA Inter. Without any coaching, I could pass both groups, and then we shifted to Chennai. Meanwhile, what I did, whenever I was free, instead of, you know, watching TV or serials when the baby is asleep, I used to go to net and see what moms are doing. To be honest, when those days in Pune, 2013, we did not have a proper internet connection, Wi-Fi connection. We had this dongle connection of mobile brand, dongle connection, and it wasn't very strong. But we had to use it carefully. So I used it carefully only to learn. There were no movies, there was no entertainment, maybe songs we could afford them. But whatever I used on, you know, text, like maybe proper websites and blogs. I learned what is social networking. I have opened an Instagram account. There is a young mom, very young mom. So that's how things started. I started connecting with people and asking them, what are you doing? And I became an affiliate for Snapdeal. After a long time, I have seen some money in my account then. Prior to that, I was working for Oriflame. I was selling Oriflame stuff, because if you sell Oriflame, they will give you some gifts. After a limit, they will give you certain gifts. So my makeup was free of cost. Just imagine that feeling, getting a 500 rupee lipstick for 50 rupees, or getting it free rather. That was a nice moment for me. And the achievements you spoke about, they are not just online for me. My work is a combination of online and offline. Every time people do this mistake that if we are online, if we have online presence, they think that is sufficient. They think we need not work offline. I have seen great, brilliant minds like that. They have a wonderful online presence. But offline, when you interact with them or you go for a deal, they will not do it. They don't go by analytics. They don't go by numbers. They don't go by the income they get. So that is a mistake everybody does. My work has always been a combination of online and offline. When we were in Pune, I was like, I knew half of what is online, and I started blogging. I started a fashion blog. I was a Snapdeal affiliate. And then we came to Chennai. So when you change cities like that, you can't settle somewhere. You cannot find a stable income. In that case, I came to Chennai and I wrote my ICW exams with wisdom teeth pain. And by the way, another thing that I did not neglect my studies because I have an online presence. I did not neglect anything. Always have a plan B. People say concentrate 100% on the plan A. See, now today is Corona time. So people who invested in one thing, they are wondering what to do next. Today, if I'm a little safe because I've invested in all the places, I've invested my time and energy in all the places, so I'm a little safe. So I did not ignore my studies because I had started to build my blogs and all. I was waiting for my ICW results. Meanwhile, in Facebook, I saw some ad for a community manager something role at a startup. It was a funded startup, by the way. It was not a bootstrap startup like the usual ones I work for. It was funded by Walden International. That's called Spinny, getspinny.com. It was way back in 2015. Working with Spinny gave me a completely different edge. Shankar believed in a woman who was just a homemaker then. Shankar Gomati Nayakan, his wife Anu, and there were team members like Karti and Girish. They were absolutely very good people. So they believed in me, and I started working for some 4 hours a day. I used to come home because like a mom drill, I was like Cinderella, Cinderella has to be home by this time. I had to be home by 3:30. So 3 o'clock, however, the important meeting was going on, maybe the most important meeting with investors also, I just used to get up and say, guys, see you tomorrow and come home. Because my child was very small then. He was like 3.5 years old. So that was the pattern I had. And I used to come home and work double hard. Because they are giving me the lenience, I have to work hard. So slowly what happened, Spinny has grown and the office was not sufficient. I offered to work from home. I was the first work from home employee out there. So I started the culture of work from home for myself. I don't know about companies, but I started it for myself. Then I went to Hyderabad and a person called Sri Charan Lakharaju of True Max, he saw me and he offered me a job in his company. I wanted to stay in Hyderabad for a year because of some personal reasons, my family reasons and all. So I went and joined TruMax. It was for 7 to 8 months. That's where I learned branding, how to brand myself, how to brand a company. I was a business development manager for them. My CEO, Sri Charan, back then, he told, you are not the person who should be, working behind a laptop. You have to be present. Your presence should be in the office or with the clients rather than, working before a laptop like this. It's not that way. You should be in front and you should be talking to people. That's how I became a business development manager. And that was more learning. Ahead, it was Frenzy, which became Advisory later. And I did a small, campaign for a company called Broadcast Fair. It was telecast. That video was telecast in History Channel. Oh my God, Amira India. So it was like exploring. And all the way, I kept my online presence well. Asking people, interacting with people, networking with people, writing about what I feel. So that's how I think my following has grown from 800 friends when I entered Hyderabad in 2016. Just 800 friends. Within a year, it became 5,000 friends with 1,200 or 1,800 followers within just 1 year.
Such and a great achievement.
Yeah, just in 1 year. I never expected that to happen. But I was very genuine. Those days, genuine things online were appreciated, shared, and the traction was more. Today, genuine things don't go online or viral. Those days, they really went viral. Now you have to pay for things to be viral, right? So earlier, it wasn't like that 4 years ago. So me being well-known in Hyderabad, I befriended some very good entrepreneurs in Chennai through Facebook. one of the most important people here in Chennai is Mr. Kumarvel, C.K. Kumarvel, who owns Natural Salon. So him and his mentees, they're all wonderful people in Chennai who run very sustainable businesses. Again, I did not rely only on blogging. I did not rely only on, you know, social networking. I relied on a side income or knowledge rather. When you work so continuously, it becomes a mixture of knowledge, business knowledge and online, like a little technical things like hashtags and all. Now I'm a social media manager. I take up digital marketing work. I take up political strategy, client interaction also. I take up many other things. I work on projects. Actually, I'm a model now. Sometimes, you know, I applied just like that on Insta for Date the Ramp, and they asked me to come. When I entered there, at the age of 34, imagine starting something like modeling at 34, after I have put on some weight. When I was slim, I did not look at all these things. But after putting on weight, it takes some courage to stand beside those beautiful, thin, tall girls. Very
but you look like a 25-30 in between.
Yeah, but I'm a 30 plus mom. You know, I'm 35 now.
Yeah, you are. So, Instagram itself is a 30 plus mom with yeah. that name only. But I think that it is, you should put it as 25 plus mom.
Yeah, I shall make the correction. Thank you so much.
Because it is not 30 plus mom. You are just 25-30 in my point of view.
Thank you. Mentally, I feel like 20. I don't know why I never come out of the 2005. I can never come out of the 2005. I don't know why. I feel like I'm stuck. When my child was born, I was wondering, oh my God, what is this? Like, you know, my life has changed. I have changed all these things, you know. I feel mentally I'm stuck somewhere at 20. I'll be honest with that. It might be immature or, you know, naive. But that is the truth. I'm stuck somewhere in 20 and I don't want to grow beyond that. I still feel like that. So you can see that I did not neglect my... That's the reason I keep that student thing alive. I'm still pursuing my ICW final. I've given it a break for 2 years and now I'm pursuing it again. When you're learning so many things, it keeps the child in you alive. It keeps that youngster in you alive. I remember when I worked with this college startup, my employer used to say, the CEO used to tell the students, see, look at her energy. She's 31 and she's the oldest in the company, but look at her energy. This was something he always said. I used to be competing with the college students when it comes to energy work, time maintaining the time in the office. I used to be very competitive in those things. So that keeps one young, I believe, all the time. We should always have that. And see, I learned makeup in the past 2-3 years. And learning something. I was selling Oriflame and just applying makeup for fun. 2-3 years ago, I started looking at it seriously. What is makeup? Why are people buying it so seriously? What is the business behind it? Why is Nykaa so good? All these things I learned. You know, all this research as an online shopper will help you in future. Really, you know, now I'm promoting products.
Even I did Yavan Oriflame.
Yeah.
I used to do Oriflame, Yavan and other Yaturu Biotech. I am a very good seller of those beauty products. But unfortunately, yeah. After some accident, I left all those things. I like marketing a little bit.
Yeah, marketing teaches so much, Gurnath, because you are looking at people, you are learning about people. And, you know, if people go to very big colleges, like very well-known reputed institutions like IITs, IIMs, ISB, anywhere, it's about people. Hmm. Usually people, we go to these organizations, we go to these institutions for education because ultimately they will leave you with brilliant Ivy League kind of network, right? We should start to build very excellent network wherever we are without a title, that is leadership without title, right? As a homemaker, as a part-time worker, I built a network. I never shied from meeting someone big or felt ashamed of myself. I'm very honest with people today. I clearly tell them, see, I make only this much. Don't, you know, over-glorify me because I haven't put that effort. If I put effort of 10 hours, 12 hours seriously, you can earn a lot in the field I'm in. Till date, I haven't, but I'm doing it right from January. From January, I'm being very serious about work. All these days, I had my studies and all. Now, Corona came and I can't write my exam. There is a lot of time. So I'm investing in this. See, I'm building my own website that is called the 35thmomfashion.com. I'm still building it. I have three brands which have come to me to promote their products. So it should always be a combination of network, education, learning at least, skill set, and always be in touch with people, be genuine. What people like in me is I'm genuine. I can't lie. See, today I can't tell you that I have 10,000 following in Instagram. I don't have. I have 1,500. Numbers always speak up for themselves, right? I can't lie to you. I can't promise you that I'm going to sell 10,000 pieces per month. I might be able to sell 10. I don't know that. So those things I can't do, I'm very clear.
See, having 100 genuine people is more than equal to 1 lakh fake people. So followers will come only if you are very genuine. So the real genuine followers will be always there lifelong, maybe till whatever the account will be.
Yeah.
And coming to your honors and some rewards, recognitions, there are few I have seen in your Facebook profile. What are they? And you have been admin of one of the mommy group or something, Simple Mom,
yeah,
or
Super Moms of India.
Super Mom,
Super Moms,
yeah,
of India.
Can you please tell more about it?
Super Moms of India started 4 years ago while working with Spinny, you know, and with the intention to promote financial independence among women, asking them to work for Spinny. It did not work for the exact intention I started it with, but as I told you, being genuine, I haven't promoted it till date. It has 900 or more than 950 followers in that, and I don't expect moms to be on the internet all the time interacting or engagement. I'm not looking at that. I just share things there. I don't spend time on that. Suppose if I find a wonderful article on women in the Indian Army, I will share it there. The intention behind that, Gurnath Garu, is that women should not give up because they got my astronaut dreams. Now I can say, see, I could not be a pilot. Actually, that was my dream to be a pilot, and it still is. See, I want to be a pilot. I can't be a pilot. My child should be the one. It doesn't work that way. Today, I'm still open to the option of being a pilot. I will be a pilot. I will fly one day. I'm very sure of that. Even with spectacles, I'm telling you that. That one fine day, I'll fly my own plane. I know that. I really know that. I will have the pilot license. I have to keep my options open. Else, you are passing that to your kids also. Like, if you can't achieve something, you should push it on your kids. I could not be a celebrity, so my kids should be a celebrity. I could not be a doctor, so my kids should be a doctor. This should stop. And women, second thing, we don't market ourselves. If you look at my profile, why is it so well known? Because I marketed myself. I clearly said, this is my skill. This is what I'm known for. This is what I did. If you do not give credit to yourself, you do not praise yourself or are confident about yourself, the world will not believe in you, right? You should not be scared of yourself. Like, let's say the entire world is against me today and I know what I have done. I'll still stand by myself if I'm right. That's how it should be. Because, you know, people don't first have faith in themselves. They want a God to believe in. Right? They want a leader to believe in. They want a family member to believe in or depend on. We are so scared of ourselves. We don't give ourselves the credit which we are giving to an invisible being out there. What can, you know, I am not an atheist. I'm not a very believer too. But then, see, God may exist, may not exist, but me relying on him is me insulting him. Me telling God for things which are in my hands, which are in my capacity, God, I should pass my exam, is telling God, I don't believe in the intelligence you gave me. God, I don't believe in the brain you gave me. So I'm relying on you.
Yeah.
Right? Praying that God, let everything go smoothly, maybe it's fine. But God, help me pass the exam. God, help me become rich. That's not the thing, you know. I believe it's insulting him. So I believe firstly in myself rather than others. I have seen things, I have relied on others and lost. Everybody, now you see all the quotations, the source of quotations on internet is betrayal, right? Everywhere people say that they cheated me. I believe in people. I believe they will help me out. I believe they will be with me. Yeah, people are in there with me. But it's fine for me. It's really okay because I'm there for myself ultimately. So moms should be having this kind of individuality for themselves. And the kind of conditioning we give a girl child is that, you know, he's going to keep you happy. Before marriage, what will he say? See, it's going to be a very new thing, very new experience. what is new there which my parents could not give me or I could not give myself before marriage? What miracle is going to happen there? This over-relying on husband, over-relying on children. Children become a source of you loving yourself. I have children to live for. We should be living for yourself, right? I love my children more than myself. Yeah, I love him, you know, to the moon and back. If the situation comes, I will, of course, prefer him. But then when the children grow up in that atmosphere, they are not respecting the mom once they grow up. They are thinking, okay, she'll sacrifice. Okay, today the food is not sufficient. She's sacrificing because she's always sacrificing. So mom should not be sacrificing. Like, mom should be self-nourishing. Mom should be self-nurturing. Children will learn that from you, right? I wouldn't like it tomorrow if my son goes in that sacrifice mode for everything. If he tells his children that, dude, I can't be this, I couldn't be this, so you be that for me. I really wouldn't like that to happen. So I think even moms should understand that factor. Moms should understand the thing that children pick up from us. And when we are speaking of girl child and empowerment, why are we not working? Why are we not equally working as men? Why are we not building empires like men? We want rights, right? So let's take responsibility also of building something. So if you look at my profile, I'm the first one in the family, maybe in 2-3 generations, to come out and show my face in public.
Yeah.
So that is the kind of a person I am. I was never shying. And I tell you, I come from a very poor background. I'm not shying away, you know, from telling this. I come from such a family where any child could be mentally traumatized. I'm not getting into details, but that is a thing. But I was the most confident girl when I went to the class, when I went to the college, when I went to any occasion, any place. I've seen that I was the most confident. It proves that regardless of your exterior, you can build yourself. We had like only my mom to take care of myself and my siblings. But that was how it was those days. It was so bad. I had to work after my BCom, as I told you. Because there was no other person helping us anyway. In that scenario also, I was very confident. And girls who had everything, boys who had everything, they were still doubting themselves. So firstly, you should have that faith in yourself. Only then you can succeed anywhere in life. It might be online or offline. And second thing, as I told earlier also, don't rely on one thing madly. Like anything happen, can happen anytime. Like you are seeing Corona now. There is possibility that what you completely invested on will collapse. So always have that plan B ready for yourself and be an expert in that. Be an expert in something. Be the role model in something. And as you said, the causes I work for come from my childhood troubles. I work for domestic violence thing. I am not officially with anybody, but I do get a lot of calls from women who are going through this situation. I see that they are not helped by their parents, even though it's an arranged marriage. That's cruel. That's very cruel. So we as a society should help these women. Most of them are not willing to take any help. They are not in a mental condition. That happens over the time when someone calls you useless for 5-6 years or maybe more. Someone beats you up every day or maybe occasionally. Someone tells you repeatedly you're worthless. You start believing that. People start believing that. That's my concern. And I really love animals. I work for them also. I always foster stray animals. I feed stray animals. I help them whenever it's possible. My mom has brought us a pigeon, especially, you know, with animals. She also helps. She never took fees from tuition students if they did not come for some days. She used to take proportionately. So that was the value system we grew up in. Perhaps that shows as service motive in social media.
On social media,
it looks like that.
And how you handle all these things? Because see, social violence and women violence, you are dealing with those sensitive things on social media. And there are always negativity and there are always negative posts. So how you manage all those stress and all while helping women whom you want to help?
There was a video, Gunnath Garu, on a Telugu channel called I Dream Media,
mm-hmm.
where a responsible police officer was speaking on how women should dress. when I many people opposed it and I opposed it. So a guy, a particular guy, he spoke about me so vulgarly, publicly. Of course, some people came to my defense. It's fine. He used some words. Perhaps he thought, seeing all these bad words, this woman will feel bad about herself and she will feel ashamed of herself. I told him, bro, what you're speaking is biology, a woman's biology. Yes, I'm a woman. I'm not scared of those words. I'm not ashamed of those words. And you're calling me some bad words, bad character and all. A woman who is successful and who opens her mouth is never called of good character. So I'm not scared of these words either. Go ahead and do whatever you want online. Do whatever you want. You know, take my pictures and post on your profile. Tell publicly that she's a bad woman. I challenged him and he backed off. He backed off.
So that's,
I challenged him publicly.
Most of the women are really scared about these type of things. Whenever people whenever people come out and tell their problems online, some guys like these guys use such abusing words and all. Women already sensitive, na? They will feel that they don't want to come again and they stop expressing themselves. So this is how social media is suppressing most of the women problems. They are
A woman complains, the moment she complains, we are saying it's fake. Recently, a CEO's wife came out saying that he harassed me for dowry for 12 years of marriage. She kept quiet.
That
she
is the unfortunate thing.
Yeah, and she put a dowry case and people said that, why does he require dowry? When they got married, he was not rich. One of his neighbors spoke up on social media saying, yes, that woman was harassed. I'm the witness. The maids are the witness. Right? But before this thing actually going to courts and verdicts coming, social media judging her as fake. If tomorrow something happens with me really and I tell online, they are going to tell this girl was model. She was wearing this kind of clothes on Instagram. So she's fake. She wanted attention. Now she's doing it for that. Yes, I'm prepared for that. The moment women are prepared for the worst, we can come out. The moment we start, you know, not being ashamed of our own biology, which people use online, cyberbullying. He wrote something very bad about my parts. Then I said, I'm sorry for saying this on your channel. But then I said, see, those are the parts every woman has. You are mom, you have parents at home, and your origin is a woman, right? Without her, you wouldn't be there. If you are saying that is your bad knowledge, and I'm proud of those things. And there are certain words they use for a woman in power, woman in who has ambition, a woman who speaks up, who is unafraid, because they want to shut her up. The ultimate intention, they can't tolerate a person who speaks so much, who thinks so much, right? A woman who wants a power thing. I was told by some people, in some scriptures it's written a woman should not be in business or in power or in politics. Like, because women can't keep secrets and something like that, some twisted things. I don't know if it's that true. Scriptures don't say this, Gurunath ji. People say. I don't think if a person, a wise person, has written these things, he would say that. People say all these things. Society says. And it's universal. Domestic violence is very universal. We think other countries are so developed, nothing happens there. No. When they apply for
particularly, divorce, India is top in this. I think there are many countries, but in India, it is too much.
Because in India, we are not completely conservative. We are not completely liberal. And in our country, women are not officially independent. Domestic violence happens less with women who are financially and socially independent and more with women who cannot get out. Because the men clearly know that she cannot get out and earn for herself. If I'm there, I can obviously go out and get a job in 10 days, right? So that percentage of things happening with me is much lesser, and you know how loud I speak. I'm an acid tongue or whatever, you know, you all know. A wrong name my mom gave me, Shanti, right?
That is what I want to tell now. Although you are very aggressive sometimes. See, the inner peace is, you have peace within you. Yeah. So that's why the name is good for you. Because you already have a peace inside you. That peace is what helping others to fight against.
I'll be honest with you, I did not start off as an aggressive girl. once I got married and I got to see the scenario, how the comparison comes, how the family background matters, a good, more than a good girl, the dowry matters. You know, I had an anti-dowry marriage, no dowry marriage, right? And how people speak about it, how they bring my background into that, how they say, you come from a family where a woman only was in charge, no man was around. So that's a bad thing. You should be affectionate with a girl like this who did not get so much love from one of the parents. You should be affectionate with that girl who stood up for something and who said no dowry. You know, my neighbors in Ramanthapur, Hyderabad, they said, we will not give dowry to our daughter because of you. We will not give dowry because we learned from you. Why should my daughter give dowry? Is it a penalty she should pay? They refused. They refused. They clearly said. So in those days, there was no internet. There was no social media. There was no SMS. Only SMS was there those days. No email kind of marketing. I had no resources. I put in Telugu Matrimony that I wouldn't like to give dowry, and there was a very good response. So 2007, I was 22-year-old. What will a 22-year-old know those days? So we have to be bold and stand by. Many people told me, are you Aishwarya Rai? Are you Kareena Kapoor? Are you that beautiful? Or do you have lots of money? Or are you having great qualification? You are BCom. Shut up and give dowry. Many people told me this thing. And those people who told me were women, most of the women.
Mm-hmm.
And those who knew me from close. Then I said, see, I believe in this. I will believe in this forever. I'd rather be single than compromise on my principles and go ahead. Now, Gurunaji, my concern is in this kind of society, if a woman really goes through something bad and she gets out and starts a new life with someone else, what are they going to show her? Even for men, I know men who go through domestic violence. I know men who go through 100 times more torture than a woman. They are not coming out of the marriages because of society. They are living in other countries. Some of them are living in other countries. They don't want to come out of the marriage because society will say something.
Yes, exactly.
Their parents will say something. Their parents, no, but they say, beta, somehow adjust. Somehow have a child, everything will be all right.
That is a major problem.
Mentality.
So it is there still in some of the remote villages and all. Still we are witnessing all those things. But most of them are not exposed, but still there.
Even in cities, actually in cities, I know many city people. I don't know village people, much of them. Because they spend a crore on wedding. We spend a crore on the wedding.
Yeah.
The girl adjusts even if he's beating you. So
there are celebrities also.
Yeah.
Even celebrities.
Yes.
But they have so they are compromising themselves because of pride and society.
Yeah. Because it's actually that fear is valid, I will say. If someone gets out, she especially women are in a little more danger. They will be seen as available women, maybe, you know what am I saying? Maybe other men
see
them
it.
As available. Now she's free. That kind of mentality. And spending too much on weddings is another evil we have. If it is all right, no problem. If we have lots of money, no problem. But going beyond our means, parents getting into debt, that's the reason they all say that a girl child is not a good option. Let's have a boy child. Let's have a male child. That's the reason most of the people don't prefer to have a daughter. So if we have lesser spending on the weddings and more on the education, it will be better. Everybody, you know, we say that. Let's invest more on ourselves. If the marriage works out, it's fine. Else, it's a bad investment, right? 25 lakhs on a wedding, 1 crore on a wedding, especially if they're violent people. They're not worth it. So, before you know if it's worth it or not, would you invest in a business? No. But we do invest in very big weddings.
It's
right?
Like a commercial thing. Marriage also a commercial.
During my life in Bidar, that is a small town, I regularly heard one thing. Those days, many people were like that. Now that place is also very developed. Beta, aapki shaadi ke liye paise hum log ko jama karna hai. Like we have to save money for your wedding and money for your dowry. So I grew up hating those two words, wedding expenses and dowry. I hated both these words. And fortunately, I started something against, and I believe I won at least in my life. More than others, I was concerned about my life. Firstly, my life. My principles I should follow, then I can tell others, right? So I'm glad I could live up to my own expectations in those aspects. I'm not going to encourage something which is bad, at least for myself. I don't know if people will listen to me, but at least from myself, I will listen to my own principles.
Actually, this series is about motivating women, especially who are shy to come online and build their career online. So most of the housewives are most of the uneducated are partially educated. They can do a lot of things in blogging or YouTube or whatever maybe. But because of these things which we have discussed earlier, so shyness is one thing, and people in our South India, you know very well, when girl faces camera or something, they immediately family people only stop, sir, why are you going there, what you are doing there, like those things.
Yes, I was very discouraged when I was 15.
These type of things
will come. Long hair, and I was very fit to be a model, very slim, and that kind
yeah,
of
yeah. Thing. Whenever I see your Insta, I was really shocked. Why Shanti has not started this in 2015? So I have your old photos, and I have saved it in my computer, and you are all very. When I compare those things to now. Very complete. You are like a very villagey girl, and
yes, I was.
So I think you have a lot of talent now. I was really shocked about these 5 years
back then. I'll be honest with you. See, I never wanted to be a rebel. I never wanted to be, something very different. I tried to fit in that normal thing, Gurunath Garu. I wanted to be a normal, conservative girl like everybody else. I guess that's not in my destiny.
No, you are you are the real Shanti now, because you should be like this. Yes. Only. So I think the old Shanti is like a village girl who is going there.
Yeah, trying to.
It's a normal human being. You are now like a dynamic personality, and you are giving so much of motivation and also encouraging many people, and also living as an example for many people who are suffering. To come online or just feeling shy or something like that. So it is an encouragement thing. You please go ahead with this personality only.
Sure, thank you so much.
And coming to your startups, you attended many startup events and all. Are you a startup by yourself, or you encourage startups?
I encourage startups. I'm an enabler, and in a couple of days you will see an update. I'm going to be an official enabler somewhere in a consulting firm. I'm an enabler because, again, I was a homemaker. I know the importance of money. When these startup guys have very big visions and they don't have monthly income coming in or clients coming in, even for salaries, that is concerning for me. You can build a brand, but you got to have some revenue in order to be successful, right? Funding is not a solution for everything. If I want to buy groceries at my home, will I go to a bank and take loan? No, right? I have to rely on my salary. Every month I should have some income from my work or my job, and then I will go for groceries with that amount. I will not go to the bank and say, see, I don't have money for groceries, or I will say something fancy like I want to build a home and then take a loan and buy my groceries. That's not the attitude I'd like to encourage. First, become sustainable, then ask for funding. Funding should be for a startup expansion, not for survival. Right? For surviving, you should have your regular income. If your model is fantastic, investors only will come and invest in you, right? Why going for so many pitches? And even in pitches, numbers only matter. If you are investing they are investing 1 rupee, they expect at least 3 rupees to come back. Nobody is going to invest in a company which hasn't made any great revenues for 4 years or 5 years. 6 months is the gestation period. With that attitude, I guide them. I help them find people who might buy their product. Unless and until it's rocket science, you can make money, right? At tech, we can make money easily. If the product is very valuable, colleges will come and buy your product. Schools will come and buy your product. Students will come and use your product. So that's the value you have to give. You have to build a client base, you have to build a user base, you have to build a customer base, and build your revenue model on that. Numbers speak very much. Because I'm a commerce person, perhaps I was always strict about numbers. People hated me in the beginning. In Hyderabad, when I spoke the importance of, being sustainable, having clients, some people really hated me, and I was out of their firms pretty soon. They believed in hype. They believed in, speaking very great things and as a CEO, as a person who runs a company, that responsibility will be to take care that operations are well and clients got what they wanted. Or you should appoint a very trustworthy person who will deliver the results to the client. But very few CEOs sit in the office and supervise things. No need to sit in the office, actually. In 2 days, you can see the analytics, what happened to a campaign, what's happening, like what kind of work you have given to the client who paid you. So that kind of attitude. Vision is good, but execution should also matter, right? After a while, execution actually matters. In the long run, that matters. So that's how, that is my approach towards startup. And regarding, we were talking about women. I was the only mom in that particular startup I worked. Suma, where I worked, that was my first bootstrap startup where I learned a lot of things. So I was the only mom out there. I was the eldest out there, 31. The youngest being 19. The CEO himself was 27, and everybody else was younger to him except me. I was 31, and I really enjoyed that phase of being, you know, well experienced.
But only number is 31. You should have been same age group with them.
Yeah, mentally yes.
Visually.
Yeah, I agree. And another thing, women shy away. If someone says you're good looking, they say no, I'm not. Really, whenever a guy, any human being, any male especially, when they tell us, a guy was very surprised when he told me that, Shanti, you're beautiful, you'll sell any product, you look good. I said, yes, I know that. And he was like, oh my God, no girl said yes. Girl said, no, I'm not that good looking. No, you are just being kind to me.
To be frank, you are not beautiful. You are charming, actually. So you look very charming. Beautiful is different thing. You look very charming. that is one good thing. Yeah.
And when women achieve something, all the credit is given to the family. All the credit is being given to people who are supportive towards her. Come on, we are doing every day to every man who is going to work, right? How the family dependent the conditioning made us, that's of another topic. But a woman should be a human. Any human should be intellectually independent, socially independent, financially independent. And they should have that emotional independence also. If I have financial independence only today, I'll be working somewhere with a lakh salary or something. But nobody would know me. Nobody would know my thought process. Nobody would be coming to me for help, right? It's important to have that social independence apart from your family. What are you? Apart from being Ishan's mom or Kiran's wife, what am I? So that is important to me. And ability to take decisions. Though my husband is very highly educated, more educated than me, I make sure that I take my own decisions.
Individuality is very important.
Yeah. My mother is also a very highly educated woman, but I learned English by myself.
You know how many languages? I think you are Kannada, Telugu, Tamil. You born in Karnataka?
I wasn't born in Karnataka. I was born in Vijayawada, by the way, Andhra Pradesh.
Oh. But you said you are from Hubli.
I'm Bidar, that is.
Bidar,
I'm
sorry.
I'm from four states right now.
Telugu, Kannada, Chennai. How many languages?
Kannada. Tamil, I'm a little weak, but Kannada I can read, write, speak. I can understand pretty well Kannada.
Good.
Hindi I know because I'm from Bidar. Bidar is a place where maximum Hindi people stay. We actually interacted with people in Hindi. Then my mother can Telugu, English, Hindi, Kannada. These are the mandatory languages one should know for my background. Tamil I know. Marathi I can understand. Tamil I understand pretty well. Marathi I understand very well because my best friends were Marathi people in Bidar. Bidar was a Kannada Marathi place.
It's a border.
Border area. So Marathi, we stayed in Pune for a couple of years. So that is something. Punjabi, I'm very fond of Punjabi. I grew up in
I love Punjabi community. I love Tamil also, but I only understand few words. I know only Telugu, Tamil, English.
School was Guru Nanak Public School, which is run by Sikh people. Sikhs are wonderful community where they are very brave people. Air Force Station was there in my hometown. So they were very brave guys. That, chivalry is something I looked up to. I wanted to be in the armed forces at one point. I wanted to be like them. I told you, right? I wanted to be a pilot. That was the inspiration. I looked at them with so much of wonder, like, oh my God, great guys. So that was the community I grew up with, hence this personality. When I was there, I'll be honest with you, I liked Hyderabad more than Bidar. I thought, I live in small town, I should go and be a city girl. Once I entered Hyderabad, I understood the advantages I had being in such a wonderful multi-language, multicultural community, Bidar that was. So I cherish that. Connecting the dots, I can say. Today, I'm appreciated because of so much of knowledge from all the states. You know, four states, to pakka. I feel like a local Chennai girl.
Yeah, when you know the local language, the way we speak with local people, with their language, that thing is really helpful. Otherwise, the communication is really problematic.
Pune people were wonderful. Chennai is a wonderful place. Tamilians are awesome people. And everywhere we are received well. That's the beauty of our country, despite having so many different languages and cultures. It's a wonderful place. I'm always happy being anywhere I am. I feel like local. In Pune, I felt like a Puneri girl. In Chennai, I feel typical like a Chennai girl. I love the food here. And, you know, I put on a little bit of weight because of that, eating masala dosa with ghee, butter, everything. So, yeah, Chennai is very wonderful.
That's why you look chubby. Otherwise, in 2015, you look very lean and peel. yeah, it's good. Sometimes some food will help you.
Yes. And my mom says I'm not very angry now. My temper is balanced after I put on some weight.
That is a good thing.
You know, people who are hangry all the time. Or maybe lack of nutrition makes people cranky, right? Lack of nutrition causes depression. Very few people understand this part. Lack of nutrition causes depression, that anger, the crankiness, and everything is caused by that. So, yeah, it's wonderful talking to you, Gurunath Gar. Is there anything else you would like to know?
Yeah, I want to know any final thoughts. If somebody wants to build a career in online, what type of businesses you suggest to them? Is there any opportunity?
Digital marketing. Firstly, learn digital marketing where you can help anybody go digital. Actually, I'm associated with Fanibhushan Kukadapu now. He's a political strategist of K-Hub and he's also a digital marketing expert. And speaking of expertise, I'm with Udo. I'm an evangelist with Udo, which is an app which helps you connect with experts. So in my circle itself, there are so many people who can help you gain knowledge. Get in touch with me and I'll connect with you people. That's what I'd like to say. Digital marketing classes are being conducted by people in my network, my wonderful friends and acquaintances and colleagues. I can always say just learn digital marketing now because in the next 5 years it's going to be very, very big. Work from home is going to be big. And today people ask me about work from home, the productivity and all. I've been doing it completely since 3 years. For the past 3 years, I've been working from home and attending meetings. This is going to be very big. Now, my child's school, they are going to have only online classes for the next at least 4 to 5 months. So, digital is big. Learn that. Be online all the time. Don't be shy to learn new things. First, learning is important. Then, going ahead. When I started off, this knowledge wasn't necessary. Right? It was like very simple. Now, some algorithms have come up. Organic reach has been stopped. I think only Insta is the place where we are going to have organic reach for some more days. Other platforms, not much. If you see my LinkedIn, it doesn't have much reach. I'm not working much on my LinkedIn, by the way. My Facebook and Insta have good reach.
Yeah, Insta is very popular now.
Yeah, but I always had that Facebook following. So my Facebook page is doing great. My Facebook profile is good. I would always suggest people to learn something first before venturing into these things. I'm also with some edtech firms now, so edtech is going to be the next big thing with colleges and schools not functioning like usual. Be accustomed to the new normal and learn things whenever possible and don't be afraid to apply somewhere. I applied to be a fashion blogger on the fashion blogging day on Jan 28th at Date the Ramp Chennai office. So I thought, okay, I'm not a professional model. They are anyway not going to call me. What will I lose if I apply? When I went there, they called me. When I went there, I found a girl whom I know in my network, the manager was the person whom I knew there. There, and the stylist saw me, and she recommended me to a very big silk brand, Oti. Mm-hmm. Me and my son have done that too, Valentine's Day campaign.
Yeah, I saw in your Facebook.
The dream has fulfilled out there. Yeah, and the dream, two dreams have fulfilled there, like two campaigns, modeling campaigns. So done for life. That's so good. Right, so never be afraid. First thing, don't ever be afraid to venture online. Put yourself out there. Be cautious though. Don't trust everybody. Don't give out unnecessary information. Don't befriend people. Don't look for relationships online. Please, it's very important. At 30 plus, everybody is perhaps, you know, maybe bored of their usual lifestyle. Everybody, most of us don't have much things to look forward because we are already parents and we are married. Those things. Don't look for fun or this kind of unnecessary stuff online. You get what am I saying, right? Don't look for relationships online. It's not very good. They don't last long. And they are most of them are frauds. People do crazy things online nowadays. Don't do that. Don't register yourself on unnecessary apps. This and the caution, word of caution I'd like to give. Because online means, Gurunaji, it's not just showing them the positive things. Online jobs are from online. But there are many people who lost money online. Playing unnecessary games, investing in those. Just to play games, someone spent 6,000 rupees.
That's really bad.
Be aware, be cautious, have a single goal and devote your time only to that. This generation, or generation means 5 years. 5 years ago, we did not have Netflix or Prime, if you remember, Gurunaji. We did not have much of distraction online. Now, even I'm distracted by Netflix, YouTube and Prime, all the crime things coming in there. Crime stories. I'm really fond of crime stories. So these distractions are there. Beware of how long you're watching those things. Binge learning is better than binge watching. Always remember that.
Yes. I guess if you want to follow this awesome lady, you can follow her at Instagram with name 30 plus mom. And I will also leave her Facebook and other social handles in the description below. And Shanti Garu, thank you so much for spending this much of time. You are very busy and I am very thankful for you to have this interview. It's been very
pleasure
happy for me.
Mine. Pleasure is always mine.
Thank
because
you. I am so
been
privileged.
Trying to interact for the past 5 years. Yeah.
And wish you success and also please stay home and stay safe.
Thank you. Nice
Thank
to
you.
See you.
Yeah. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye.